We're gonna go and see if we can get inside. Let's see if we can get in.
Congressman, do we have any questions?
We're going in. This is Congressman Alex Mooney. I'm calling you live from the SCIF. It is precisely 1:22 p.m.
The sergeant-at-arms was forced to make a rare appearance in that secure room, the House committee room, known as a SCIF, after that display by House Republicans today. As reported by Politico, quote, it was tense, said Congressman Tim Burchett, a Republican from Tennessee who sits on the Foreign Affairs Committee. Another person in the room said Republican Congressman Bradley Byrne of Alabama was getting in the faces of and shouting at Democrats. Oh, and for good measure, it bears repeating, the president called critics in his own party human scum today. Here with us to talk about all of it tonight, we welcome to the broadcast Joanne Freeman, history professor at Yale University in New Haven, co-host of Backstory, the podcast on American history. She's also the author of The Field of Blood, Violence in Congress and the Road to the Civil War, which we now note is out in paperback with bloody illustrations. Professor, thank you for coming in. I have a very basic question to start with. Tell us, when has it been worse than this?
The 1850s.
Okay, and what happened then?
Well, I mean, I think probably most people watching know that the end result of that was a civil war, so definitely that's worse. But the 1850s represents a time when the question of slavery was really had been building up for decades. And part of what was going on in Congress is that Southern slaveholders were protecting that institution by threatening and intimidating and occasionally really being physically violent towards anyone who opposed them.
The title, There Will Be Blood, comes to mind. When was there blood?
Well, in one case, one congressman actually killed another congressman in a duel in 1838. But for the most part, what you see a lot in Congress, I mean, in a sense, it's not unlike some of what we're seeing today. The point of it wasn't necessarily to shed blood. It was to score points. It was to make a point. It was to silence people through intimidation. So it wasn't necessarily about bloodshed. It was about bullying more than anything else.
Talk about how firearms were viewed, were carried. Were they on a per capita prorated basis more pervasive and likely to be used than today?
Well, for sure, there were a lot of firearms in this period around, but if we're talking specifically about Congress, there were a good number of congressmen who were armed. Southerners were more likely to be armed for a time than Northerners, sometimes with pistols, sometimes with bowie knives. But part of what happens in the 1850s, as things begin to really heat up with the slavery controversy, is that now some Northerners begin to arm as well because they don't trust the institution of Congress itself to protect them.
A lot of the folks watching tonight and every night are deeply worried about the falling away of the norms of American life. How many American generations, in your view, have had reason to fear for the future of the Republic?
Well, we've had a number of, and this is not going to surprise anybody, a number of extreme polarized moments. The 1850s is one. The 1960s is another one, right? And we're in another one now. I would even say the late 1790s are another one where people actually talked about civil war, right, and anarchy. So there have been a number of moments where politics has been hyper-polarized. And I think those are moments when naturally norms begin to be shattered, things begin to be disruptive in some way. In the 1960s, you had TV sort of spreading that around in a different kind of way. Now you have social media. In the 1850s, the telegraph, making things more intense because all of these new forms of technology meant that whatever was going on, all the upset and ferment, was spreading faster than ever before. So there have been other moments when people have had fears. But the important thing to say as a historian is that history doesn't repeat. So on the one hand, you can say that there are patterns. On the other hand, some of what we're going through now is distinctive to now.
What we're talking about tonight chiefly is a kind of a day of kind of stage drama, as we said at the top of the broadcast. This term we're using to describe what happened today is stunt. I don't think any jury would convict us for misuse of that term. To invoke another title, a tipping point, is there a tipping point when stunts add up and collapse under their own weight to the momentum of the forces of change?
Right. And I hesitated with the word stunt today. I kind of struggled with that. Because in a way, that suggests not to take this seriously, right? It's a stunt. And it was done for display. Perhaps it was done to impress the president.
It was done to call the proceedings secret, proceedings that 45 Republicans have daily access
precisely,
to.
Precisely. So it was to make a point that is not a very forthright point. So on the one hand, you can say, okay, it was a stunt. On the other hand, it was people within the institution of Congress disrupting the congressional process, right? Disrupting a bipartisan committee meeting and taking testimony. So to me, you know, can I say that there's a tipping point? No. But what I can say is that I would hesitate before dismissing it as a mere stunt, because I think physically, having a group of people physically disrupt things in that way, who are part of the body itself, that's, I mean, concerning, I guess, is the word that I would use. I wouldn't quite yet say alarming, but certainly concerning.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.